Good evening, brethren. Good evening, church. Good evening. Happy, happy Thanksgiving to everyone. Okay, so we know that tomorrow is Thanksgiving. And this is the day before Thanksgiving. So happy, happy Thanksgiving. And we're glad that we are here. And this is also the last Wednesday, I believe, of the month of November. So could you imagine, could you believe that we are heading to December, okay, in a matter of days. So we praise and thank God and welcome once again to Bergen Bible Baptist Church in our Thanksgiving service. And good to see everyone here inside our church and our folks who are watching online. Welcome to everyone. We have 7 million as of now. Amen. 7 million of them. Thank you for tuning in. All right, so let's start our service with some songs, and let's all rise up, please, as we sing, Thanks to God for my Redeemer. Thanks to God for my Redeemer. On the first now,
Thanks to God of my Redeemer. Thanks for all thou dost provide. Thanks for times not by the memory. Thanks for Jesus by my side. Thanks for pleasant balmy springtime. Thanks for dark and stormy fall. Thanks for tears by now forgotten. Thanks for peace within my soul.
Hold on a second.
For prayers that thou hast answered. Thanks for what thou dost deny. Thanks for storms that I have weathered. Thanks for all thou dost supply. Thanks for pain and thanks for pleasure. Thanks for comfort in despair. Thanks for grace that none can measure. Thanks for love beyond compare.
On the third,
thanks for roses by the wayside. Thanks for thorns, their stem of pain. Thanks for home and thanks for fireside. Thanks for hope, that sweet refrain. Thanks for joy and thanks for sorrow. Thanks for heavenly peace within. Thanks for hope in that tomorrow. Thanks to all eternity.
Amen. Thanks to our Redeemer, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So thank the Lord that God has given us eternal gift, and that is through our salvation. Okay, so let's sing another song. Give thanks. And I would like to request Brother Bobby to open us in a word of prayer after this song. Ready now, sing.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks.
lang.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we thank you for allowing this gathering, Lord, that we can come as a church to give you praise and thanks in this special day. Lord, we thank you as corporate believers tonight, first and foremost for our salvation. Lord, we thank you for giving the Lord Jesus Christ to die, to be buried, and on the third day he rose again for our salvation. And Lord, tonight we just want to say thank you so much for everything that you have done for us. And Lord, as we continue to desire to praise and worship you and to give you thanks, once again, Lord, we ask for forgiveness, Lord, for our sins. Please forgive us, Lord, for all the things that we have done that are not pleasing to you. And we just commit ourselves to you tonight, Lord God, with a pure heart by your grace and mercy. Lord, please be with our singing as we continue to sing the hymns, Lord, that Pastor Jet prepared for us. And also, Lord God, for the special number, the choir, and most especially, Lord God, the preaching of your word. Lord, please be with us. Guide us with the power of your Holy Spirit. Give us the right motive, Lord. We just want to thank you, to praise you, and worship you tonight. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
All right, Hannah is so noisy. Wow, Hannah. All right. So please remain standing. Can we greet our brethren? Say hi, good evening. Happy Thanksgiving to everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. Amen. All right. So please remain standing as we sing another song. I have been blessed. Are you blessed? Amen. So let's sing on the first. Now.
When he walks among us, all that he does, all of his mercy and all of his love. If the pen of the writer could write every day, even this world could never contain just how I've been blessed.
On the second.
The warmth in the winter, the flowers in spring, the laughter at summer, and the changing of leaves. The food on my table, a good place to sleep. Clothes on my back and shoes on my feet. I have been blessed. God's so good to me. Precious are his thoughts of you and me. No way I could count them. There's not enough time. So I'll just thank him for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been having a Savior who pardons my sin. He is my friend, my master and king. He's preparing a mansion for me to live in. And someday he'll call me, for sure I'll go in. I have been blessed. I have been blessed, God's so good to me. Precious are his thoughts, you and me. No way I could count them, there's not enough time. They're so thankful for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed.
Can we repeat the chorus in the choir wheel? Get ready, please.
I have been blessed, God's so good to me. Precious are His thoughts of you and me. No way I could count them, there's not enough time. So I'll just thank Him for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed. God has been good. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed.
Amen. God is so good all the time. Amen. God is good. You may now take your seat and let's listen to our choir.
Maker of all things divine,
Amen. All praise to you, Almighty King. And brethren, that's the reason we are gathered here tonight, isn't it? We just like to give thanks. We just want to give praises to our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, for all his many goodness and all the benefits that we receive from him. And happy, happy Thanksgiving Eve service to all of us. I hope you're happy. You're glad to be here. Amen. And we praise and thank God for his goodness and his faithfulness. We are able to reach this far in our lives, be able to celebrate together with patriotic Americans across this country, the traditional Thanksgiving Day, especially as we commemorate that special day tomorrow. And you know the history about this, isn't it? Whereby our the Pilgrim Fathers of this great country had sought religious freedom, and God gave them their desire, their prayer, and with a lot of hardships, they were able to survive and be able also to give thanks to God for blessing them with a good harvest and an opportunity to have a fresh start in this great country. That was 1620 when the Pilgrim Fathers arrived here through the Mayflower, and that's like about 401 years from the time. And throughout the years, it was proclaimed as a national holiday by various presidents. So we celebrate together with the Americans. But as we know, as Christians, Thanksgiving Day is not just on the last Thursday of the month of November, but for a child of God, Thanksgiving is every day. Amen? Thanksgiving is Thanksgiving for a Christian, because every day there's still something we can always thank God for. And we thank God for tonight for the celebration of the wedding anniversary of Sister Astrid, I believe, and Brother Chris. A happy, happy wedding anniversary to this sweet couple. And may God bless your marriage and your relationship together as you serve the Lord together and know him more as the years go by. So congratulations. And also is Brother Jason Madigan's birthday today, I believe so. Isn't it? So I think he turned 24 years old, something like that. Still looks so young. And thank God for another year of life that God has given to him. And also I saw Sister Kyla, you know, visiting us all the way from the Sunshine State, you know. So we praise God for the exciting few months that she's been in Pensacola, and we thank God that she can visit her family, see her grandma and grandpas here in New Jersey. So we thank God for the traveling mercy that God has given to them. And also, tomorrow is Thanksgiving Day, so enjoy it with your family and friends to whatever dinner or lunch that the Lord provides for you. But you'll have like a preview tonight, because even though it's going to be past 9 o'clock, we're still going to have something to eat. And we'll enjoy it together. And we thank God for the kindness and generosity of our people, of God's people here in Bergen, for just contributing something for us to enjoy. All right? And Friday, we will not be having any joint Bible study, Friday joint Bible study, because most of you are sleeping after eating a lot of turkey. Oh, somebody says shopping. All right, maybe it will be a black or gray Friday for you this coming Friday, but it's going to be family time. So I'm not going to ask you to come here in the church for our TGIF, but enjoy it with your family and friends. If you want to have your Bible study, go ahead and do it with your family or your group, but I think we'll enjoy it with our families and friends. All right, so you have a little break. So this Saturday, we will be having, of course, the choir rehearsals for our upcoming Christmas cantata. So continue to pray for our kids and also especially our adult for doing that. And also, do pray for me. I was invited also by Pastor Manny Herrera to supply for his pulpit as he travels after Thanksgiving to visit his family in South Carolina. So I'll be in Massachusetts on the first Sunday of December, December the 5th, I believe. So do pray that will be a blessing there as we minister to our daughter church. All right? And tonight, we won't have our regular prayer time for the sake of the occasion tonight. But we'd like to ask our folks here in the church, maybe two or three, if there is something that you would like to thank God for specifically. All right? Any volunteer, we'll give you the mic. So our folks from watching us on the live stream can also hear your praises unto the Lord. So anybody? I know there's a hymn in our hymnals, Count Your Blessings, isn't it? Name them one by one. And that's one of our favorite songs in our Bible study group. But it's not just one by one that God showers his blessings upon us, isn't it? It's really manifold. It's tremendous. It's a lot. I'll just want to ask you if you want to share one or two from our congregation here. All right? Yung hindi nakatingin sa akin, tatawagin ko. All right. Biglang tumingin sila. Sige na po, wag na kayo maya. All right, Pastor Abel. Thank you.
All right, since no one's raising their hands. All right, so I know that we have so much to thank God for. First of all, I would like to thank God for my salvation. Thank God for his sufficient and wonderful grace that I was able to experience a lot of years ago. So I just want to thank God for this relationship that I have. And also, specifically this year, you know, we just thank God that everything is trying to get back to normal, which mm-hmm. is really a big blessing. Last year, we weren't able to celebrate this Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. But this year, we were able to. So I believe that's one of the things that we need to thank God for. And also, personally, this year, I started a new job. And I wanted to thank God for that because my previous job, I only worked for 28 hours. I was not really full-time. But for this year, I'm working 40 hours a week, like Monday to Friday. And like at first, I thought that I wasn't able to, you know, make it because of like the things that I'm doing for the church too. But I just really thank God for his sustaining grace that I was able to do it. And the year is almost ending. Mm-hmm. And I just really just want to praise and thank God for it. So I thank God for that and also this church and also for my family. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Abel, for sharing that. It's a blessing. Anyone else? Ayun, Sister Kate, please do so. Thank you.
I'm thankful for my sister coming back mm-hmm. and Amen. That I got an A on my driving test.
Yeah. What? You already took your driving test?
Mm-hmm. 2 years early.
Yeah, that's what
and
I thought.
And that's it.
Wow, praise God. Our kids are really growing, you know? And thank God, of course, their family is complete this Thanksgiving Day because Ate Kyla is here with us. So praise God for his provision and for the wisdom and strength, knowledge for that test that she passed. All right. Thank you for sharing. Who else? Isa pa po? All right. Sister Judith, please come to the mic.
There's so many things to thank God for, but I just want to thank God for my salvation. Mm-hmm. And I just want to thank God in behalf of all the healthcare workers. It's been a tough year. Mm-hmm. And a lot of us had been like really gone through a lot of challenges, trauma, and stress and anxiety in our jobs. And at the same time, I thank God for his provision every day for our health. Mm-hmm. A lot of us are all our COVID survivors. That alone mm-hmm. is another blessing to thank God for, another gift of life that he had given me personally and a lot of our church members as well. And I want to thank God for our church. And Thanksgiving is also time for family to gather together. I thank God for bringing my sister back again to the U.S. Mm-hmm. It's just her and me now. Our parents already died and our eldest brother. So we're really very close, and I just mm-hmm. thank God for her the protection that he gave her for traveling without any mishap or any challenges. She had a good flight and everything, and thank you for all the prayers.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Judith, for sharing that. Of course, yes, we always thank God for our healthcare workers, our frontliners there in the medical field, and everybody who works in those places for the Lord's strength. protection, and also the answered prayer in our sister's behalf that she made it here in the U.S. safe and sound. So let's continue to pray for our frontliners. Amen. And we thank God for their lives, for their sacrifices, also for the support of their family. For me, of course, we always thank God for our salvation. And I thank God for family and friends. And of course, this year also has a little bit challenging. But we thank God for another addition to our family, for baby Ezra. As you know, he was born premature 6.5 weeks earlier. But look at him right now. It doesn't look like a preemie, but through God's abundant grace, he is growing. And we thank God for his health and, of course, the continual comfort and strength the Lord has given us as a family and even as a church, you know, as we know in the passing away of Pastor Max. And we'll truly miss him, you know, on these special days, on these special occasions. But we know he's in the best place that a Christian could ever be, in the presence of God, and we have that hope that one of these days we will be reunited with him in our departed loved ones and friends in the Lord. But while we're here, we have a job to do, amen? We have a work to do for the Lord, so let's keep on looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. All right, last. All right, Sister Rachel, okay. I have to say it again.
I praise and thank the Lord. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
All the hiccups of my life, I praise and thank the Lord for the goodness and the protection that he has given me. Thank you.
Amen. The sister Rachel's testimony. This is the fourth year. She's cancer-free, so we thank God for the Lord's healing, protection, provision for her. And Brother Nestor, and we thank God for her life. All right? So I believe that's about it. That's our time for our sharing today. So what we're going to do, we'll ask the ushers to please come. We'll have an offering for tonight. And part of our worship and praise is to give unto the Lord. So whatever the Lord has blessed you with, may the Lord bless the gift and the giver tonight. And let's continue to pray for our church, for our missionaries that we support all over the world. And also, let's continue to pray for our Faith Promise Missions program, that the Lord will allow us to reach our goal. And also, our newly elected officers, and we will announce them this coming Sunday. And also for the plan for the upcoming year for our church, that the Lord will bless. All right? We'll have a quick word of prayer for our offering. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for this offering that we have tonight, for the gift and the giver. Thank you, Lord, for giving to us the greatest gift of all, your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, for our salvation. Bless now this offering for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for giving unto the Lord. And tonight, before we hear the message from one of our deacons, Brother Glenn, I will have a special music from Sister Robin, as always. Always available and willing to share the word of God through a song. So after her special music, Brother Glenn would come. Thank you.
I can't help but think about the Lord and all the things He's done. He meets my every need. You know He's been so good to me, and I can't help but praise the Lord for all He's done. For all He's done. Praise the Lord for all He's done. There are many things that I could praise God for. And if I started now until I died, there'd still be many more. If I could mention only one, I'd have to thank Him for His Son. Now that's enough to praise the Lord for all He's done. For all He's done. He's done.
Amen. Wow. Praise God for the message of that song. And again, thank you sa atin pong lahat for coming to our special Wednesday night prayer meeting. Okay. Praise God again for that. Let me remove this. Yeah. Parang hindi ako makahinga eh. Wow. For a while, I thought I'm in a Sunday service. And every time we come here during our Wednesday night prayer meeting, I mean, obviously, we don't have the choir. Now we have the choir. I mean, we have we have a lot of people inside the church right now, thank God. So sabi ko, parang Sunday service. Sana every Wednesday, pray, ganito, no? Amen. Amen to that. Yes. So we have a lot to be thankful. Tonight is a special night because obviously this is a Thanksgiving night for all of us. And I believe also, obviously, this is the last Wednesday for the month of November. Because next week is what? Christmas week. And also, this is the first Thanksgiving. Obviously, our dear pastor Max is not with us. And I always kid with him every time we have this Thanksgiving. And then I always tell Pastor, when you do your Black Friday shopping, don't forget me. My size is XL, okay? I just kid with my. But thank you again, brethren. Again, I am honored and humbled to be the one to speak. Nagkataon, ako pa yung magsasalita for tonight. And I really thank the Lord for our church. We have a lot to be thankful. Look at this. Thanks. Give thanks. Happy Thanksgiving. I mean, it is not only during Thanksgiving that we should thank the Lord. Amen? As a matter of fact, we have to thank the Lord every day of our life as a Christian. And I really appreciate the sharing of blessings, the sharings of gratefulness. I always hear every time we have the Bible study, they start with thanking the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for my salvation. I don't take that lightly. The fact of the matter, that is very important. I mean, without the Lord Jesus Christ, we cannot have salvation. And thank God we have eternal salvation because of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen to that. And thank you again, Robin, for singing that wonderful, wonderful song, For All He's Done. We have to be thankful with a lot of things in our lives. Some people take it lightly, but the fact of the matter is we have to really thank the Lord for everything for all He's done. Amen? So, again, by next Wednesday sa ating prayer meeting, sino sa inyo gustong si, ano na, si Sister Cora na kumanta bago ako magsalita? Ha? Amen. Okay. Narinig mo, Sister Cora. So, next week, o next time na magsalita si Brother Glenn, ang kakanta? Iyon. Okay. Ipagdasal niyo, ha? Just pray for it. But thank God. So, tonight, we have a special, special message. And obviously, the message for tonight is about being grateful and thanksgiving. So, buksan po natin ang ating banal na kasulatan. And my text is very, very familiar to all of us, actually. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, and this is very familiar and very short, but at the same time, a reminder to us of why should we be very thankful to the Lord, not only during Thanksgiving, but every day. So, 1 Thessalonians 5, and we will be reading only 3 verses, 16, 17, and 18. And you just follow me right here. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16. Rejoice evermore. And I have to put my eyeglasses. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. Very, very familiar. In everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, once again, Lord, thank you, Lord, for your love to us. We cannot be thankful enough for the grace, for the love that you have given to thy children. As we look forward for the celebration of Thanksgiving Day for tomorrow, we can't help but thank you for all that you have done. May it be small, may it be big, in everything we should give thanks. Thank you for the wonderful salvation that you have given us through your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Without him, we are nothing. Thank you for our Wednesday night prayer meeting for tonight, for allowing us to be gathered once again, be admonished by your word, and be reminded that you are our Lord of Lords and King of Kings, and the one that gives us all the grace. Father, we love you and we thank you. Guide my lips, Lord. Guide the words that will come out from my mouth that will be a blessing to thy children. We love you, we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. So, our lesson for tonight is titled, I believe, narito na, Give Thanks in All Circumstances. I was actually reading some of the quotes about Thanksgiving, and a lot of people are saying, thank God we will have a turkey for tomorrow. Thank God for the stuffings. Thank God for the delicious ham. Thank God for all the food. We are very excited. Some people say, thank God that we have this house that we live for. The most important attitude that we will be ever nurtured, that we can ever exhibit in our life, is the attitude of always being in thanksgiving. I've never met a person who is always not in the mood if he is always grateful. Find a person who is always grateful and you will find a person who is always smiling and contented. I am more convinced of that every day. The attitude that makes the difference is an attitude of being thankful and gratitude. For some of us, living out a life of gratitude is a major obstacle. Then that is a problem. Some people have a hard time trying to be grateful because they feel it's an obstacle. It's not that we're not grateful, but we have trouble focusing on it as part of who we are on a daily basis. And tonight, I will try to change that by means of our lesson through the Holy Bible. As part of my illustration and introduction to my message, there was a cartoon not long ago of a family gathered for a common meal. The father said to the mother, "I don't want to complain about leftovers, but haven't we already said grace over this meal 3 times already?" Now, in the Philippines, when I was still growing as a young man, sometimes it's not only 3 times, 4 times, 5 times. And we just, you know, sabi nga, Pilipinas, pinapainit lang. He didn't want to complain about leftovers, but the fact of the matter is he did. He wanted to give thanks in all circumstances, but found that a little bit difficult to do because they're eating leftovers for 1 time, 2 times, and 3 times. Now, these verses that we just read is very imperative. Number one, we should rejoice always. We should pray without ceasing and thanking God. Give thanks in all circumstances. You know, mahirap? That's the most difficult part. Give thanks in all circumstances. But Brother Glenn, what if I have a problem? Should I still give thanks to the Lord? What if I have a problem with my child? Do I still give thanks to the Lord? What if I just got fired from my job and I don't have a job anymore? Should I still give thanks to the Lord? Yan po ang pag-usapan natin. Mahirap, di ba? Pero from the biblical standpoint, we should find out why, in spite of that, we should be thankful. So there are great challenges, and tonight we will focus on giving thanks in all circumstances. And I repeat, all circumstances. Now, what is included in all circumstances? So tonight we'll be talking the first one. Number one, in all things, obvious, we should give thanks. What do you mean obvious, Brother Glenn? So what does that mean? What does that mean that in all things obvious, give thanks? 1 Thessalonians 1. Tignan natin, ha? 1 Thessalonians 1. Let's open our Bible. And let's take a look at verse 2 and 3. Ano sinabi dito? We give thanks to God always for you all, making mention of you in our prayers, remembering without ceasing your work of faith and labor of love and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ in the sight of God and our Father. Wow. Ano ba yung mga obvious na sinasabi dito? Paul gives thanks to God and at the same time thanks the Thessalonians for what would appear to be obvious things. Sometimes the obvious thing is the easiest thing to take for granted. Amen? The next time you recognize the following thought in your mind, as you hear as you say it aloud, stop and take notice. Ano sinabi? It goes without saying, but when it comes to gratitude, it does not go without saying. That is why we should always say thankful. The fact of the matter, again, is do you remember the story of the 10 lepers in Luke 17 that were healed by Jesus? It is a biblical story. 9 went on their way and only one came back to thank Jesus. That one person, a Samaritan, knew that it doesn't go without saying. It doesn't go without saying. The first opportunity of giving thanks in all circumstances and thus changing our attitudes in our lives is to give thanks for obvious things. These obvious things are the people and the blessings that are so close that we look right past at them. The obvious blessings, we take it for granted. We should thank our wife na nagkaroon tayo ng wife na katulad niya. We should thank our husband. We should thank our children. Some people take it for granted that we have a house to live in. We should thank the Lord. We have this church. Amen? Amen. Did you know that I came across a some Christians down in the Hackettstown, New Jersey? And these Christians, we just had a conversation, and I was really shocked to hear what they said about their pastor. And they said that, Brother Glenn, what church? Obviously, I said Bergen Bible Baptist Church, okay? And then, do you have a pastor? Of course we have a pastor. We are just renting pastor. Huh? Ngayon ako nakarinig dun, ah. Renting pastor. They have a small church in Hackettstown. They're also a Christian. But they are renting a pastor. So every Sunday, they have a different pastor that they pay on a per diem or per message. And why is that? We're still looking. So in other words, I thank God we have Bergen Bible Baptist Church and we have a permanent pastor. Yes. Amen. We have a permanent pastor, and we not only that we have a permanent pastor, we have a handsome pastor. Amen. Amen. Diba? We have a very, very good support. Pastor Abel, Pastor Jether, Pastor Abel. My goodness. We got to be thankful for that. Amen. And not only that, we got to thank our congregation. And sometimes people take it for granted. Thank God. Lahat po binibigay sa atin. Those are the obvious things. The food that we eat, sometimes we take it for granted. But again, I will venture to say that all of you obviously pray before you eat. But most of the people out there, especially those who are not Christians, they take it for granted. They just eat and that's it. Nothing. No prayer, no thanking. Just eat. That's it. Thank the little things that God has provided us. Gary Stradman went to the Bethel Bible Training in Madison, Wisconsin, and several of the teachers were descendants of Norwegian pioneers. Are you familiar with the Norwegian pioneers? Now, here's what happened. They like to tell stories about themselves. That's the Norwegian way. And the Norwegians, they said, were not known for expressing feelings of thankfulness very freely. One of the speakers said that he knew a Norwegian farmer, however, he loved his wife and appreciated her so much that one day he almost said thank you to his wife. He doesn't want to thank. He doesn't want to be grateful. And the fact is, sometimes we are like that. But thank God, I was really blessed a while ago. A lot of us giving thanks, expressing our gratefulness to God. Amen to that. Psalm 103:2, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Think for a moment of the benefits of being here inside the church right now. It is so cold outside. And we're here warm, and we're about to eat food. Amen. We can laugh, we can sing, and have constant fellowship, wonderful fellowship with each other. I mean, a lot of things to be thankful, which are obvious. But some people take it for granted. So we should give thanks in everything obvious in our life. It doesn't really matter if it's small, but we have to be thankful with all those small things and obvious things. That may sound silly, but it is not silly. Forgetting to give thanks to God who created our marvelous body. Kahit na mataba nga, salamat sa Diyos, may body ka, di ba? Amen. Yeah. Sabi nga ng misis ko, Dad, paano yan? Tataba na naman ako, sabi niya. Sabi ko, okay lang, kain ka lang na kain. Mahal pa rin naman kita, kahit tumaba nga. Di ba? Amen. Yeah. We are to give thanks in all things obvious. Number two. In all things obscure, give thanks. Obscure, what do you mean, Brother Glenn, by obscure? What does that mean? It means opportunities that are hidden, people we don't see right away, things that seem of little value until we take a closer look. Ano sinabi dito sa Philippians 4:8? Sige. Yan. Ano sinabi? Sister Cora, pakibasa mo nga yun. Ito na pala eh. Diyan mo na. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Amen. Again, those verses are very familiar. You have read that several times. But sometimes it is obscure. When you say think about these things, this means to take inventory, to calculate, to stop and ponder and think about them for a while and begin to see the things that is obscure and beyond our casual seeing. Give thanks for whatever is true. Anong sinabi? That word is a wonderful word. It means not only that which is true in terms of truth-telling or honest speaking, but also those things that are solid of lasting substance. It is not what withers away, is here today and gone tomorrow, but the enduring things, to give thanks for friendships and that just blow away in tough times, to give thanks for our marriages, for our children, for our jobs, for our pastors, for our church, in anything obscure. Now, there's a good illustration right here. The president of Princeton Seminary was speaking at a conference, and he told about his daughter who came to him one day and said, listen to this. The daughter said, Dad, I've looked around and there just aren't any good marriages. So I am so discouraged. I don't want to get married anymore. Wow. And obviously, I mean, even if I don't ask you, you and I know that there is really a lot of bad marriages outside. It is true, yeah. But he gave his daughter a great response. And he is the response of the president of Princeton Seminary. He said, I'll tell you one marriage that's good. It's the marriage of your mother and I. It's the marriage of mother and I. And the daughter said, Daddy, it doesn't count. And he said, it does count. And that's what I want to say. It counts. It counts to give thanks for those things that are true and those things that endure. It doesn't matter. Obscure. But you still have to be thankful in what is about to happen in anything in our life. Paul says, whatever things are lovely, think on those things. This suggests that whatever people are lovable, whether the people are lovable, give thanks for them. There is a famous psychologist who calls some folks, listen, noxious people. Do you know of people who are noxious? Ano ibig sabihin nun? There are people who seem to make us sick because they're always negative and then pointing out our faults and inconsistencies. Yung mga makukulit. Diba? Wala silang magawa, kundi puro negative. But he says there are also nourishing people in our lives. Give thanks for those who nourish you, who feed you, who are part of God's gracious plan to build you up. To find those things that are obscure, we need to sit down and consider what God is doing in our lives. Sometimes we have to pause in our lives. I know that we are all busy, everybody's working. Sabi nga nila, in America, for some reason, the time in America is so fast, unlike in the Philippines. Sabi nila, bagal, speedy bagal in the Philippines. But here, it's so fast. And some people are telling me, wait a minute, we just started January, now we're about to end it, and it's a new year again. Yeah. Fast. You know why? Because everybody in this country is what? Busy. In the Philippines, we have a lot of what? We have a lot of lag time. Walang magawa. So, it is matagal. And to find those things that are obscure, we need to sit down and consider what God has given. Take a piece of paper. Sometimes you have to write it down. You will find things that are obscure, things that you normally do not thank God for. But listen, you have to thank God for everything obscure. God gave me the ability to read the paper this morning. Salamat, may salamin ako. Kung hindi, hindi ko mababasa ito. God kept me safe in my travels. God supplied for me the food that I eat every day. God allowed me to laugh. Did you know that some people are having a hard time to laugh? Yeah. God gave me the opportunity to witness today to someone. God gave me a paycheck today. Amen. So I can buy shopping on Black Friday. Thank God we have a congregation like this. Thank God that we are brothers and sisters in Christ who are here inside the Bergen Bible Baptist. Thank God we have a pastor. We don't rent a pastor. God gave me his word to read and meditate upon and be blessed upon it. And God heard my prayers today. Thank God. Those are obscure, but very important. If you will truly think about your blessings at the end of the day, you will find that you'll never run out of things to thank. Thank God. Even in those things that are obscure, we should all give thanks. Sometimes we forget, but we should give thanks. Now, the last one is very important, and I want you to listen very carefully. In all things, objectionable, give thanks. Wow. I put it in the last because this is the most controversial of giving thanks. And this is where a lot of Christians sometimes are having a difficulty in trying to be grateful because of this objectionable, we should give thanks. I saved that the toughest one. In all things objectionable, we still have to give thanks. Do you mean to say, Brother Glenn, that I still have to give thanks for this very terrible problem that I'm experiencing right now? Am I supposed to give thanks, Brother Glenn, for this thorn in the flesh that isn't being taken from me? Am I supposed to give thanks, Brother Glenn? I just got fired from my present job and now I don't have any means of income. How am I supposed to pay my rent? How am I supposed to pay my mortgage? Am I supposed to give thanks? That's really tough. But if we have to have an attitude of thanks that can transform the situation according to this, we are to give thanks in all things objectionable. I know in your mind right now, you are thinking, it is objectionable and it is very hard to give thanks when things in my life are going down instead of going up. And I understand that. But let's look at what the Bible says right here. Colossians 3:17. And whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Let's notice one thing that may help us. Paul says, give thanks in all circumstances. He did not say, give thanks for all circumstances. There's a big difference between those two words, in and for. There is a big difference. Even in the worst situation, I can give thanks to God that it will not always be that way. A lot of people have questioned why God allowed what happened at 9/11. A lot of innocent people have died on that tragic event. And even the most faithful Christians, some of them have questioned God. Why did you allow people to die? People who are innocent, children, men and women who died there, why did you allow that? Quite naturally, you may say, I'm not able to give thanks for those things. But listen, it's right here. Sometimes we have illnesses. Or I'm not able to give thanks because of this person that has offended me. As a matter of fact, inside the church, sometimes, you know, sometimes we are offended by the brother or the sister. How can I give thanks? Give thanks for the presence of God in every situation. Thank God that even though the circumstances are negative and tough, He is still by our side. Thank Him that even through you had a setback or a negative event that happened to you, God is still able and willing to redeem the situation. Begin to realize that even though the worst circumstances, God can work still in the midst of our life. You realize that those things that happened in 9/11, that God allowed it? I mean, it's hard to explain, but a lot of Bible scholars have mentioned and have attested that while those things are happening with those terrorists, God is still in full control. There is all reason behind it. He is still in full control. Reminds me of the powerful true story of Corrie Ten Boom. A lot of you know who Corrie Ten Boom is. I remember reading about Corrie Ten Boom because I one time I was able to have a chance to read the book of Corrie Ten Boom. And here's what I noticed, and I'm just going to share it to you. Did you know that she died in 1983 after many years of serving the Lord? She and her family lived through the Nazi Holocaust, and they hid Jewish people in their home who would otherwise have been killed by the Nazis. When she herself was placed in a Nazi prison camp, it was such a flea-ridden, terrible place that she couldn't stand it. Her older sister, Betsy, said, "Corrie, but I have found something in the Bible that will help us. It says, in all things, give thanks. I can give thanks for the fleas," Betsy said. "Give thanks that we're together. Most families have been split up, but thank God. Even though we are still inside the Nazi camp, we're still together." She found something to be thankful for. Even though they are in the Nazi camp, they were in prison during that time. It says right here, and her sister continued, "Give thanks that somehow the guards didn't check our belongings and we were able to have our Bibles with us." She gave thanks for that, but Corrie would not even think of giving thanks for the fleas. Listen, Corrie Ten Boom refused to give thanks because of those fleas, a lot of fleas in that prison camp. Later they found out that the only reason they were not molested and raped and harmed by the Nazis is because these Nazis hate those fleas. So they don't go inside those prison camps, they don't do sa mga cell, because there's a lot of fleas and the prisoners. The guards at the prison hate it. So they were prevented from being raped. And the sister said, "Thank God for the fleas." And Corrie Ten Boom said also, "Thank God we have this fleas." In the town of Enterprise, Alabama, there is a monument in the middle of the town square. Who have been in Alabama here? Wala pa. Okay. Sinabi dito. Right in the monument in the middle of the town square. You probably think maybe it's a Confederate general. No, it's not. It's a monument to a boll weevil. Have you heard about that? Boll weevil. Kahit ako, hindi ko alam kung ano yung boll weevil eh. Pero I found out, it's just right here. A boll weevil is an animal that actually destroys cotton. Why did they put a monument of this boll weevil right in the center of the Times Square that they have in Alabama? It says right here, they learned to plant. Here's what happened. That town depended on cotton. In 1915, the boll weevil destroyed their livelihood. They destroyed everything, those cottons. And because of that, what happened is now, instead of those people living in Alabama just planting cottons, they decided to plant other things. And this is a constant reminder that because of that, Alabama during that time went to a very good economy and they prospered because they don't depend anymore on those cottons. And they learned to plant a lot of things also. So now, up to now, they have a flourishing economy, not only because of cotton. So they thank God for this boll weevil. And sometimes in our life, things happen that you may not like, but in the end, you will find out, ay, ganun pala, kaya pala nangyari sa akin yun. Did that happen to you? In my life, I have several things that happened negative. And at the time, I'm thinking to myself, why did this happen? But eventually, I mean, I realized that the reason why that happened is because something is about good to happen. If not for that negative thing, this positive thing will not happen. The Old Testament patriarch, si Joseph, alam niyo na, di ba? They sold him into slavery. But what happened? You meant this for evil, but God meant it for good. You know exactly what happened to Joseph. Objectionable. We should all give thanks. I will never forget my true story. Before I came to America, I applied for a U.S. visa in the Philippines, obviously. And I don't know about you, but my dream is to go to America because every time I see the pictures of my cousins, I salivate. They have the grapes, and I was like in the Philippines, I was telling myself, oh, when will I go to America? And then eventually, I tried to apply first time. The consul told me, reject. Okay. During that time, there's no appointment in the U.S. Embassy. You can go every day. Now you have to set an appointment, and I believe pay 7,000 pesos. During that time, every day. So the next day, I'm back. The problem is the same consul that rejected me is the one who is in front of me. You again? Declined. The next day, I'm there. And believe it or not, that is the next, the same consul again. There's like six consuls. For some reason, I always end up in that consul. My goodness. Monday. Friday noon. Monday, I'm back. Pila uli ako. Make a long story short. After 9 times of applying for a U.S. visa, on the 10th time, sabi sa akin ng consul, what will you do in the United States? Sabi sa akin ng kaibigan ko, kailangan patawanin mo siya, patawanin mo. I want to go to the United States because I just want to go to Disneyland and shake hands with Mickey Mouse. And by that job, for some reason, he gave me a visa. And But I learned to be thankful. Obviously, during that time, I'm not still in our faith. I'm still in the old faith. But I really thank God. And you know what I did? The day I landed in Los Angeles, the first thing that I did was to go to church and thank God. In everything, we have to thank God. The things that we have right now, our pastor, our church, it may be obvious, it may be obscure. Especially me, it may be objectionable. Let's always have a grateful heart. Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for tonight. We cannot thank you enough, Lord, for the things that you have given us. The grace, the eternal salvation. We should only live for you, not for ourselves. Your greatest gift is your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you once again, Lord, for the opportunity to share your word. And I will include also in my prayer, Lord, that food that we are about to partake. Bless the hands that prepare this food. Thank you, Lord, for this blessing. We love you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you.
Amen to that. We praise and thank God for the message tonight. And once again, thank you for joining us. For our viewers online, God bless you. Have a wonderful Thanksgiving celebration tomorrow. Enjoy it with family and friends. Never forget to give thanks to God always. God bless. We'll see you next time. And here, we'll have our fellowship around the table. So let our folks prepare something. So thank you for everybody who had come and contributed for everybody to enjoy. Thank you so much for your kindness.